More than a few years ago, I moved to New York to pursue my desire to be in theater. Big New York City theater. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to theater. I'm your usher. I wear the costume of importance. The white shirt, the polyester vest, the fabric of validation. Okay, yes, I'm an usher. Maybe you've seen me telling you where the bathroom is. I moved from Boston to pursue my desire to be in theater. I'm on camera a lot. Actually, almost daily. Yeah, on surveillance cameras. Auditioning can be very demoralizing sometimes. I remember once thinking I heard, she can't act her way out of a paper bag. Well, excuse me, but if I'm in a paper bag, I don't think I'm gonna act. Remember that expression, I'm not a doctor, but I play one on TV? I've rewritten it. I'm not an actress, but I pay enough union dues to play on TV. Still have my Betty Davis eyes. The only thing I have in common with her, oh, except I lived in a dump. And I do have hope I will score a Susan Sarandon look-alike gig.
Yeah.
It's 8:01. Chimes chime. Lights flicker. The last signal before curtain. The crowd's kind of settled in. This guy with his mother who has a walker is cranky because there isn't an aisle seat for his mother who has a walker. Sir, did you buy an aisle seat for your mother? No! So he storms by me, intent on getting an aisle seat, and he goes to talk to someone in charge because obviously I don't know who he is. Yes, I do. He's cranky. And there she is, in the walker. It's okay, I'm gonna get into my seat. I'll get there. Well, we don't have time. I have to remind people again and again that there's no cell phone use, no photography or recording devices allowed in theater. I mean, really, no kidding. But now that everyone's cell phone is a camera and a recording device, there's just indiscriminate use of it. Before performances, I've seen people take photos, selfies, and before a performance, people will upload the photo, and then during the performance, people will check on the upload, and they might take a call, and they might take a photo, and they'll check their messages, and they'll check all of their social media, or they're going to text. I mean, there's a lot of this going on in the sacred space of theater! My God! Who's the asshole with a cell phone? Everybody! It's 8:07. It's magic time. A hush has descended. After the coughing fit, I indulge my love of theater. I'll be right with you. I immerse myself in the unfolding, opening musical journey. Here's a playbill. I take the trip to make-believe. Fucking nanosecond. Body odors? Weird smells, like a chicken dinner right in the front row. I see chicken dinner. Smelly chicken dinner. So, who needs to cough? Who needs to sneeze? Somebody need to unwrap a noisy candy? Okay, who's gonna fart? Besides me. Oh no, there's a fucking latecomer for the middle of the front row! Jesus, people are late! Next latecomer is a man in an overloaded wheelchair. He motors in during a very quiet moment. He's loud and he's late. And rustles around to get settled and turns off the rig. Jesus. Is that a tuna fish sandwich? Shit. Head usher tells me I have to say something. Shit, the timing. Excuse me, sir, you'll have to put the tuna fish away. Sweet. Back to the show. Rachel. No, no, he whirs up again to move a millimeter forward. And then back. And then forward. And then back. And turns the chair down, and it has this lingering sigh. Only to turn it up so we can adjust the seating angle. He adjusts his seat 3 times. The guy in the seat next to me goes,
why are you late, arts patron? Shows start at 8, unless it's a 7 o'clock. Shows start at 8.
Why are you late?
Why are you fucking late? Oh! Fucking shit ass! People are late!